Alexander Kariba in the lead with Christian right behind him, Andrew in third, Ryan in fourth, same positions they started in. And then we got Team Orange running fifth, sixth, and seventh. Coming through five, nobody's challenging yet. Still run a single foul. Space nicely, it'll allow a single foul for turn six. The last three orange cars, what are the driver's orders? Oliver, Stern, and Vizioli. Alright, so far, single file down the back straight. Now Chris is going to pop to the outside on Alexander. Going to try that all the way around again. Jeff Stern with some lock up in the rear bias. Alright, pop onto the front straight. Alexander's going to lead the first lap. Christian in tow. Got in his little head fake, tucked back in line. And you got Andrew Doby and Ryan Nash. And then a little gap back to Team Orange. Out of two, we got Kariba, Cabangca, and Andrew. Going into three, and heading through turn four, same order as before, but they've pulled a bit of a gap to Team Orange here. Coming through five, still single file. Looks like Cabangca might get a run going into six. Gonna stay single file, and they're pulling away from Team Orange. Heading into turn 8, same order as before, should be exciting. Now they're all nose to tail, might look for a pop early on the straightaway. There is an early pop there, RC. Let's see what he can do with it. Cabangca to the outside. Looks like they're side by each. Got a nose, but again, short way around by... Alexander's gonna hold point. So basically on chase, caught a copy of lap, and Cabangca does a little head fake just like lap. So pretty much the Groundhog Day all over here at turn one. Kelly is going to one. Oh, and we have a spin from Jeff Stern going into one. But it looks like everybody's out cleanly. Yeah, I saw, I'm not sure who took to the median there. It's Oliver, but something must have happened. His car must have turned off. Yeah, he's got it into gear now. Just in gear. Alright, so everyone has continued from turn one. We had the night. 14 car spin and continue negative 4 off, and Oliver had to go straight. Going 19 rejoins. Correct though. So top 4 up the inside again. There's already a pop by Christian to the outside. Ryan goes to the inside of Andrew. And Ryan is going to pick up D3. Down the front seat, Cabangca goes to defensive because he's not close enough. Might be a full long time trying an outside deal. That's probably not going to work. It's not. Oh, he's going to try. But he's... like Oliver's coming in too. You got two cars in the pits. They might have had contact. As they
track out of turn 6. We got Kariba in the lead by about 4 car lengths with Christian right behind, with Ryan behind him, and Andrew behind him. Not sure if there's going to be any files or passes.
Yep, so far single file all the way down to the first back patch. Black patch there, RC. Alright, Andrew going to the outside this time. Alright, Alexander, I should say, Andrew up the inside of Ryan, not going to get it done. A little bit of lockup, tucks back into fourth. Biggest spacing between the four cars coming to you, Phil.
Yeah, kind of all strung out with two car lengths between them all.
Single file out of two. Looks like Andrew's going to have a run on Ryan. See what happens. That is RC. Heading into turn four, we got Kariba with exactly zero gap now after a 5-car gap last lap, with Ryan still in third, same order as before.
Turn 5, it does look like Cabangca is reeling in Alexander slightly. Good spacing, it looks like those things, single file going in the 6.
Coming through 8, we got Cabangca right on Alexander's gearbox. Might have a pop about midway down the straightaway. Everybody pretty evenly spaced.
He head fakes a little bit by the wide part of the track. They are nose to tail coming in now. They're going Ryan to the outside. Not sure he's going to be able to do anything with that. Just a head fake tucks back in. Alexander, Christian, Ryan, and Andrew.
Yeah, you called. I'm not sure what Ryan's strategy is. He really needs to be to the front of this and put the pressure on Christian mentally. So, unchanged order going into one.
Just a nice train on track coming out of two. No change in position. As we head into turn 4, everybody about a car length apart. No room for mistakes here.
Through 5, Cabangca's trying to close that gap before we get to the main straightaway, the back straightaway. Oh, he's popping a little head fake. Trying to get inside Alexander's head, but they single file through turn 6, same order.
As they head into turn 8, we got Alexander Kariba still in the team lead, but everybody's a lot closer than any lap we've had before. It's gonna be wild.
Oh boy. Early pop by Christian. Early pop by Andrew. Then you got Alexander and Ryan up the inside.
Ryan might squeak through this. No, he bobbles a little bit.
It's side by side with Christian and Alexander. He's going to tuck back into second.
No position change. They pop on the front straight. It looks like one car.
Little head fake from Christian. He's not going to do anything with it.
Four, same order as usual, no passes, no pops. I want to see some racing.
Everybody's being pretty cautious on this one.
Order and same spacing coming up this thing.
And they will definitely stay single file. Very big spacing actually going through this time around.
Heading in the 8th thing, we're heading down to turn 10 for some more excitement.
Alexander all by himself up the inside. Late move by Ryan, I don't know if that's going to do anything, just...
in a hold position again for this lap. Alexander, Christian. Houston, Ryan, and Andrew, rounding out the top 40, you fill.
Yeah, a little, like you guys called it, pretty toned down from yesterday. Exciting, three passes per lap deal.
So we got a new fastest lap from Andrew Zobie, fourth place, getting a good draft out of the top three. Heading through turn four, same order as usual.
It looks like Cabangca's trying to work with Alexander maybe to try and break away, but looks like it'll be a four-car battle for the rest of the race. Same order, a slight gap from second to third place.
Heading through turn eight, we got Cabangca right on the back of Alexander. He's gonna be making an early pop.
Got you call the race, Scott, as he comes through 10 and out through 11. Yeah, it kind of looks like one of those, like, you know, early childhood development toys with the colors and the police face. Cars look beautiful, easily prepared, and awesome mechanics there for, you know, supplying perfectly equal race cars. Awesome. Out of two, all four drivers not making one mistake, not missing an apex.
Starting to think these guys are rope nose to tail, like there's just something attached and I'm moving. Not that right.
Like those figure eight chain races.
Cabangca keeps challenging into the last turn though, right?
The Miz outbreaks himself all alone here, P5 into turn one. What's
up with that, Gary?
Halfway, 15 down, 15 to go. We are at halfway. We do not need to flag that.
Ryan closer than ever in third place. This is going to get exciting here.
Hugs up on his feet down here. There goes an early pop by Christian.
He's getting closer. It's going to be three wide. Ryan to the outside. Three wide. Andrew just watching everything in the back. And it'll be no change for position, just drama for the corner.
Alright, Christian has, Alexander has a 2-car length lead. That's gonna whittle itself down to 1.5 in the braking zone.
Starting to fall back a little bit, but he closes up under braking.
I'm really surprised Ryan's not making more moves to get to the front because he needs to put a car between him and Christian. Andrew's starting to challenge Ryan. It looks like he's right on the back of him. So 1-2 is breaking away very slightly from 3-4 coming into turn 6.
Tracking down to turn 8, same position as always. Laps are kind of winding down for him. Bravo for Ryan at the track up 10.
That's opened a little gap, and Christian all over the back of Alexander, but I've called 3 cars back to Ryan, 2 cars back to Andrew.
Ryan with a new fastest lap, 28-2. Feeling it.
Good draft. slightly back, lost a little bit of time to Nash there. Eight single file, going into six. Side by side for the front two though, that's going to help Ryan out close back up, he's not giving it up, and at the apex Alexander slams the door. As you called it, Ray, Cabangca had a funnel back in, down to three, starting to drop Toby just a little bit, Andrew better hustle, he's got, you know, he's in danger of losing the draft. Andrew's about three cuttings away from the top three.
As they come through turn four, same order as always, about a car length and a half between everybody.
Pop if someone doesn't make a pass.
just pops to the outside. There's going to be no change of position. They are side by side at the apex of 10, but Christian's going to have to concede and tuck back into second.
Andrews dropped back about a car length. Yeah, Christian goes a little defensive. Ryan finally pops. Ryan down the inside. Way one. Ryan Nash, P2.
And a check from Ryan Nash on the charge to catch for Eva. The mouth of two car lengths up.
Tracking out of 4, heading to 5. Alexander now with about a 4 car gap.
Nash did a good job to grab that second, but Alexander's going to try and stretch his lead. Nobody challenging from second to third, but looks like first place has about a 5 car gap.
Tracking out of turn 8. Cabangca all over Ryan Nash. Let's see if he can do something.
Alexander stays outside. Christian has popped on Ryan to the outside. He's all the way around him. He's going to turn in and be in front. Although Ryan challenges mid-corner, they're side by each now. And Ryan's going to smartly bail out. They kind of fight through the corner, which is not working to Ryan's best interest. Ryan really needs to win, and Cabangca needs to be T3 in order for him to win the championship. Dobie looks up the inside, not going to happen. And now Alex is extending the gap about a second and a half from Christian Kareem. Cabangca now. Yeah, Ryan really needs to work with Christian now, even though he needs to beat him, because he needs to have a car between him. And he has to win it and have a car between him in order to win the championship.
5 minutes, just under 5 to go.
Alexander's really stretching the lead now. And I don't know if Ryan's going to work with him, but he does. He absolutely has to at this point. And once again, Alexander stays outside. Can throw a wet blanket over the other three cars. Ryan pops now. He's going to try to take the wrong way around. Not going to happen. He sucks back in. That's just giving Alexander a little bit more breathing room. Alexander's loving it. He's looking in the mirrors and loving it. He's got his head down. He knows the drill. Perfect pass. Out of 2 now, we just got a tight second, third, and fourth place. Alex has the lead is extending to 1.8. He's got his head down now. I don't know if he'll be able to catch him before then. Police stays range for second, though. Thought he's going to challenge in the 6.
3 minutes. 3 minutes from main. 3 minutes.
Copy. 3 minutes to go. All right, once again over the noise. Alexander stays outside. Wet blanket over the last three cars. Andrew pops to the outside. He's up alongside Ryan, but they're going to have to settle back into where they were, and I see the huge smile on Alexander's face. White flag. Next time you see the leader will be the white flag. have Stern and Oliver to come by you first. Stern's getting up on Nash here, trying to challenge 3-5. He loses a little time through the corner, and second place is about even spacing, single file.
Heading into turn 8, tracking out is Alexander while they're at the apex. No pops fast at all, I don't think, or is that? I think Ryan's gonna run.
Again, Alexander up the outside, Ryan does pop early at the passes. They're side by side going by the tower, he gets in front. Ryan got around Christian, just beyond the apex. First one. And just got to run though. Christian P3, a little gap back to Andrew.
Christian knows all he has to do is dip behind Ryan. Let's see how this all plays out though. Got Andrew in the mix.
Good exit out of two for Cabangca, but doesn't look like he hoped. He looks like he's probably surpassed, but doesn't take it.
Banga's all over Nash, heading into five with Andrew closing. Alexander stretching a huge lead. Coming up to six. Cabangca might look to pop. No, he's extremely close to Nash. Going through turn six.
Checking out turn eight for the final time. We have Alexander out in the lead. Looks like Cabangca's right on the gearbox to Ryan. He's going to be able to pop to the outside really early.
Looks like he's using a little bit of the wide track. One, just a little bit to third. He is up on the inside. It's going to be three wide. Coming in for B234. Very close racing. Cabangca does get the point. Oh, we got side by side. I can't see it. I don't know. I think Andrew got the last spot on the podium. So Cabangca definitely P2. I wasn't sure about that P3. We have to consult timing he's going for that one.
Car 15, Andrew.
Copy that, Andrew Dobie, P3, the podium, Alexander, Christian, and Andrew.